Hi guys, we will solve the lab infinite money logic floor. The level of this lab is practitioner and the goal is to buy a lightweight lead Lisa jacket. We have the default credentials Vina and the password Peter and let us access the lab. Okay, first make sure that you proxying your traffic through Burp and in Burp deactivate the intercept is on button. Switch back to your browser and click the My Account link and here put in the username Wiener and the password Peter. Click the Login button, don't save. And you see, we are logged in and our store credit is $100. Okay, go to the shop, click the Home link. And here you see, you can buy a gift card. Click the View Details button and scroll down to the bottom. And here click the Add to Cart button. Okay, go to the checkout site and here you see we added the gift card. Switch to the store site and scroll down to the bottom and you see here you can sign in for a newsletter. Put in any mail address, I use summer at hacker.com and click the sign up button. And you see we received a coupon named sign up 30. Click OK and go to the checkout site. In the coupon section, type in the name of the coupon sign up 30 and click the apply button. You see we received a discount of 30%. Now click the place order button and copy the gift card code. Copy to clipboard. Okay, now click the My Account link. And here you see there's a gift card section. Put in your gift card code that you just copied and click the Redeem button. Okay, now switch to Burp and here open the HTTP history and look for a post request to the endpoint slash gift minus card. This one looks nice. And you see here there's a code that we applied some seconds ago. Okay, now open the project options. And in the session handling rules, click the add button. Add a new rule. I leave the name as it is. Open the scope tab and here in the URL scope section activate the radio button include URLs. Okay, go back to the details button and in the rules action section add the or click the add button and choose run a macro. Okay, now under the select macro add or click the add button and now look for the four requests. The first one is the post request to the endpoint slash card. The second one is the post request to the endpoint slash card slash coupon. The third one is a post request to slash card slash checkout. The fourth one is the get request to the endpoint slash card slash order minus confirmation question mark and so on. And the last one is a post request to the endpoint slash gift minus card. Okay, then click OK. And in the macro editor window, mark the get request to the endpoint slash card slash order minus confirmation question mark and click the button configure item. Okay. Click the add button in the customer parameter locations in response. In the parameter name, put in the name gift minus card. And in the Response Section, scroll down and mark the gift card code. Okay. Okay. Click OK twice. One, two. Now click the post request to the endpoint slash gift minus card and hit the button configure item. In the parameter handling section, look for the parameter gift card, and here in the drop down menu shows the option derived from prior response, and here is the response for. Okay, click OK. Now in the macro editor window, click the button test macro. And you see we received in the macro tester a 200 OK for the get request to the endpoint slash card order minus confirmation. And also an HTTP 302 for the post request to the endpoint slash gift minus card. Scroll down and you see there's a new gift card code. Okay, now click OK, 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 OK. Now go to the HTTP history proxy and HTTP history and look for the GET request to the endpoint slash my minus account. Send this request to Burp Intruder. Open the intruder and here open the positions tab. Click the clear button and shows the attack type sniper and open the payloads tab. Here in the payload sets section shows the payload type null payloads. Generate in the payload options section type in 412 payloads and switch to the options tab, and here in the request engine section change the number of threads from 5 to 1 and start the attack. So now we have to wait until the attack finished. You can look in your browser. If you hit the refresh button, you see that our store credit is more than $100. Click the refresh button again and you see the $199. Now we have to wait until the attack finished. Okay, now we almost finished the attack. And if you hit the refresh button in your browser, you see our store credit is $1,299. Okay, now you see we finished the attack. Close the intruder attack window and hit the refresh button again. Click the home button and open the Lether jacket. Add one to your card, scroll down to the bottom and click the add to cart button. Go to the checkout and here click the button place order. And you see, we solved the lab.